All right, this is Anna Galletly, and this video lecture is going to be the second part in the nervous system series, and we're going to be looking at part one of brain anatomy. All right, again, you've got your notes slides, which are my notes put into slide format. I'm not going to read them to you, but refer back to them whenever you need to. I'm going to start going over the pictures. All right, here we are looking at the cerebrum. So you've got two different ways to refer to the cerebrum. You can call it cerebrum, right and left cerebrum, or you can call them the right and left cerebral hemispheres. And then the cerebrum is broken up into gray matter and white matter. Whoops, white, okay. The cerebral cortex is gonna be the outermost part, which is your gray matter. So this is on the outside mostly, although there is some in the inside, and then the white is on the inside, okay? So the cerebral cortex, right, this outermost, the gray matter, the first thing you see when you cut open a head and you rip open the dura mater, the first thing you're going to see, the first thing you touch is the gray matter. So what you want to do is you want to take your hand, and I want you to put it on your forehead. All right, the forehead, all right behind it is your frontal lobe. All right, now you notice that I wrote eyes down here because I'm trying to get you oriented. So you've got above your eyes, behind your forehead, the frontal lobe. Now over here, I want you to come over to the temporal lobe, and I want you to touch your ear. The ear is where is the temporal lobe is deep to your ear. Now put your hand on the back of your head, all right, also called the posterior of your head. Now you're touching your occipital lobe, okay? Now this right in here, I want you to touch the side or kind of the top. That all is parietal lobe. So both blues and pink and red are parietal lobe. Now separating the parietal lobe into two sections, you have your central sulcus. Let me change colors. What color would be good? Let's try green. The central sulcus. It's a very distinctive landmark that you will know. Okay, separating the parietal from the temporal lobe, I have my lateral sulcus right in there. We have other ones as well, like right in here, you have the parietal occipital fissure, okay? So a sulcus is kind of a deep groove, a fissure is a really deep groove, okay? And we'll look at another fissure in just a second. Now that was 1, 2, 3, 4 lobes. There is a fifth lobe that you basically have to stick your finger in here and lift up and down, and you will see it in there. I don't know how they decided it was a lobe, but it is, okay? All right, now remember I said stick your finger in here? Well, you could also use a probe. You basically stick it in and you lift up, and you can take another one and you can lift down, and it's this little area in here. Now, if we do a coronal section through here, you get that view, and you can see that the insula is just this little section. And I'm sorry, this is all in Japanese because I couldn't find a good picture of it on the web except for at these Japanese websites. So what do you do? I think it's Japanese. It could be Chinese. Anyway, never mind. Anyway, what does it do? So again, you want to know the basic functions for all of these things, and use my slides because I boil it down to the absolute minimum that you need to memorize on function, all right? So emotions, homeostasis, self-awareness, cognition, that's what you're doing in the insula. So processing. All right, so now we have a brain that has basically just been taken out of the skull, all right? Now right here, this is anterior, all right? I want you to think eyes, okay? And then back here is the posterior. So that's where you get smacked on the back of your head. Now, what you'll notice is going down the center, what happened to my arrows? They didn't all transfer for some reason. This is the longitudinal fissure right in here. And this separates the right and left hemispheres. Okay. Now, right here is the central sulcus. Okay. And that is going to separate the precentral gyrus. So a gyrus is a ridge, okay? A sulcus is a depression, and a fissure is a really deep depression, okay? So I've got my pre-central gyrus, and then I've got my post-central gyrus. They do different things, which we'll talk about in just a minute. But this central sulcus is really easy to see and it's very distinctive. Now, all of this that you're seeing right here, let me do a different color. All of this right here is your parietal lobe. Whereas up here, that's going to be your frontal lobe. And back here is going to be your occipital lobe. And then you can kind of see a sliver of the temporal right there. All right, next slide. All right, so remember that when I was talking about the cerebrum, I mentioned that you had white matter and you had gray matter, okay? And that the gray matter was in the cortex, all right? And then the white matter was deeper, okay? Now, we've got another type of gray matter called basal nuclei. And this is basically, I think of it as islands of gray in the white matter. Okay? Now, what do they do? So we've got three basic functions. Controls repetitive movements, modifies voluntary motor actions, and regulates attention and cognition. Now we've got some special things that we look at, all right? We've got this corona radiata, which is gonna be these fibers going out like this, okay? We have the corpus striatum, which is called the striped body, and you have the putamen and the caudate nucleus, which is gonna come around, and it's got this cute little thing, and then on the end is my favorite, amygdala, because then it's not quite the same, but I always think of Star Wars. I think it's amygdala, but amygdala is close enough, all right? And then you'll see a section of the thalamus right here next to it, okay? So, what you need to know the corpus striatum, and you need to know the nucleus, and you need to know the thalamus. Those are the things that you're going to get tested on, because you can see them in some of the stuff that we're doing, but I feel like I can't put the slide up without putting putamen and amygdala on it. So there's that. All right, next slide. All right, now we are looking at a sagittal midsection through the brain. We've stripped out the dura mater, the falx cerebri, and what you'll see is the cortex of your right hemisphere, okay? And we're gonna start looking at the different structures, okay? So let's start down here with my pituitary gland. So right here, you see the pituitary gland. What does it do? It makes hormones, and that's all you know. That's all you need to know right now. All right, so you got the pituitary, then you've got the infundibulum here. All right, that's a stalk that connects the pituitary to the hypothalamus because you've got stuff, because they need to communicate in order to get the hormones secreted correctly for homeostasis. The pituitary stores some of the hypothalamus hormones and so forth. Now, all in here, this is your hypothalamus, all right? So hypo is below, and that means right here is the thalamus, okay? Now, what you need to know for the hypothalamus is right here. What you need to know for the thalamus is right there. So easiest thing to put on a test, gateway to the brain, sorts and edits, real easy, okay? Now, sitting on top of the thalamus right here, you see the fornix, and then epithalamus is here, and we break the epithalamus into the choroid plexus, which is full of ependymal cells that make cerebral spinal fluid, and then the pineal gland, which makes melatonin, all right? So these things are both together part of the hypothalamus. And then below the hypothalamus, inferior to the hypothalamus, are these little things, two little bumps. They're called mammillary bodies. Do not call them mammary bodies because that sounds really weird. It's not two boobs hanging off the hypothalamus. It's the mammillary bodies. And these are relays for the olfactory system, which makes sense because your nose is right about here, okay? And then they also play a role in the limbic system with emotions and memories, okay? All right, now again, notice that I've put stars on everything that's on the terms list. So these you need to know, and you need to be able to identify it on the picture, give the name of it, and give the basic function of it, okay? All right, on this slide, I am just kind of overwhelming you with the complexity of the hypothalamus. So you notice right here is the hypothalamus, all right? Right here is the thalamus. You've got the adhesion right there. What I want you to notice is all the different colors. And what they're trying to do is show you all the different functions that the hypothalamus is packed into this tiny little structure. Then you've got your infundibulum connecting it to the pituitary gland. So this is a sagittal section. Now over here, we're gonna look at a coronal section. And what you can see now is the thalamus. And what I want you to notice is that you basically have two sides. You've got a right and you've got a left. And then there's a little adhesion right there. And what I think of is the adhesion is where the two sides kiss. All right? And you can see this right here. Otherwise, in here, and in here, and in here, you have the liquid that fills the third ventricle. So the thalamus kind of wraps around the third ventricle, and then so does the hypothalamus. So this right here is the hypothalamus, okay? All right, next slide. Actually, we're gonna stop right there so that we can keep these videos short, and what you can do now is go on to part 2 of brain anatomy.